The most beautiful place in the world, where a Tar Heel blue sky blankets Murphy on its way to the Tennessee border. It's a long way from Raleigh and the Outer Banks, but we're living in Carolina too. In fact, you might call it extreme Carolina. With more, here's Michael Borkman. Heading down
south to the land. Welcome once again to the hot new show, Extreme Carolina, where we feature guests and topics related to Clay and Cherokee counties. Today, we're blessed to have Mr. Clay Logan of the world-famous Possum Drop. He's the originator of the world-famous Possum Drop. And he's also a veteran of the United States Army. And thank you for your service, by the way, sir. And besides that, he's the owner of Clay's Corner in Brasstown. And he's a county commissioner. He's been married one time to the same girl. I like that. For many, many years. Got 8 grandkids, 7 boys and 1 girl. We'll talk about that in just a few minutes. And he's a conservative, church-going man. He's a busy, busy guy. You could be considered one of the hardest-working men in Clay and Cherokee County. And again, welcome to the show, Clay.
Thank you. Thank you. You know, when you're having fun, it's not considered work.
You know,
when you enjoy what you do.
Awesome. You know, I've heard that before. Of course, some of the folks that I've worked with on jobs, they're not smiling a lot, you know. So I don't think they're having too much fun because they're looking at the clock saying, well, I got to go see you. But anyway, we want to really, really thank you. And I want to touch on that real quick, if I can, Clay. With you being so busy, how do you find the strength to do all that you do?
Well, you know, I don't look like it, at it as a job. I look at it as trying to help people. I enjoy helping people. And if there's a situation come up, you know, we just try to figure out some way to solve it. So, you know, it's if we have to put in a little extra time or something like that during the day to do that, then that's just – and I don't sleep but about 4 hours a night.
And yeah, I was thinking I was the only one that did that. I don't sleep very long either. And I get up and think about the next thing I got to do the next day. But one of the things, what is I noticed that you told us about being a part of the U.S. Forestry Service. Do you still do that, or that's something you pass?
I retired about 6 years ago from that. I worked at the Beach Creek Seed Orchard down below Murphy. That most people work, when they're in the U.S. Forest Service, they work all over. Me, I went to the same job every day. So we had 250 acres under fence down there, and I had a real sexy job. What I did was breed trees. And, you know, somebody said, well, how'd you do that? I said, it ain't real easy. It's just getting the two trees together. Just getting them to talk is the hard part.
So the same trees and under the same, what you call it, under the same fence for two?
Yeah. We had 3 or 4 varieties of pines and white oaks and red oaks and black cherry and walnut and dogwoods. And it is a situation that lets the universities come in and work. Mm-hmm. Like University of Georgia came in and did a study on dogwoods are dying.
Really?
University of Tennessee came in and done a study on butternut, because there's a canker that kills the butternuts. So we provide the place and we provide the work, and they come in and do the studies. Like, we plant the trees and grow them, take care of them for them, awesome. And then they come in and do the studies on them.
Oh, okay. Well, thank you. Once again, everyone, we're here today with Mr. Clay Logan, the originator of the Possum Drop. We'll probably talk about that in a second. But thank you again for telling us about the sexy job with the trees. I don't think I've ever heard it quite put like that before. But somebody's got to do it, right?
Right. You got to have fun out of it, you know.
There you go. Enjoying our work. And you've had quite a few jobs in your lifetime.
Well, I guess you could figure out I just never could keep one, don't you guess?
Well, that could be the case. Or a lot of people wanted you to help them in their endeavors and doing the various jobs.
Well, the first thing I wanted to do is stay at home. I didn't want to go to Atlanta or Asheville or have to move out of our county. So when you do that, you've got to be pretty versatile in what you do and find jobs that help you grow as you get older and stuff. So that's one of the reasons I had so many different jobs. Some of them was a little political, and if when the wind blows, you sort of get changed, you know. So, but some of them was just by luck that I applied for jobs at certain times, and it just worked out good that way for me.
Okay, well, and thank you for that. You mentioned some of them are political. You are the commissioner, or one of the commissioners in Clay County. Is that correct?
That's correct. One of five.
One of five, and you've got the. Is that a? Is your time to be vote on this coming election, or are you set for this time?
I'm set. I've got two more years before
two
I
more
run
years
again.
Ago. Yeah. Is that something that you truly enjoyed, or have you really been putting the Clay spin on that position, or are you just going through the motions?
No, I really enjoy it because I really try to help people that's got problems and help them solve their problem. And these people called us like the other day. The guy said, they drive by my house at 55 miles an hour. There's no speed limit on this particular road.
Okay.
And if there's no speed limit in North Carolina, it's automatically 55. You know, and he said, years ago, I tried to get it changed, and it didn't go nowhere. And I said, well, let me look into it. And a month later, we had 35 mile an hour signs up on his road down through there. So
Wow. It's
just keep pushing and getting a hold of the right people, and don't let it get on the back burner and forget about it.
So what you're saying, if I can follow up with that, as citizens, if we are really truly interested in getting laws or getting some things changed in our communities, especially here in Clay and Cherokee counties, we need to contact our commissioners, and you guys will actually follow up. In other words, all we have to do is reach out to you, because a lot of times some of us think, well, you know, this is the way it is and it ain't going to change. But someone and several people have approached you. So what would be your advice to the citizens? In other words, just like what you just said, call you up, give you a call, come by and see you? Or how do we do
that? Yeah, this, that. Just come by and let me know. And I look into it. You know, you just don't jump on it because somebody says needs to be done. You got to see if it's feasible to do and see if it's what the majority of the people want. Mm-hmm. You got to do a little your homework on it. But if it's feasible, then you contact the people in the note to let them be aware of what's going on. And most of the time, it works out good for them.
Well, thank you. We appreciate that. As we're going here to talking about, before we take a break, I want to, at the top of the show, you had mentioned that you are one, or actually you and the one that you've been married to all this time, got three boys, eight grandchildren. And one of the eight is a girl.
Is the prettiest, smartest granddaughter I've got. She is a joke, and she is almost ready to turn pro playing golf. She is a super golf player.
Really?
Matter of fact, she's playing in a little series around here in North Carolina, South Carolina, and Georgia, and she is leading in that series right now. And she's got maybe one more competition to win the whole thing. So
wow.
She won this weekend, and she's got one more, and she's doing great.
Awesome.
We done got some colleges are looking at her, and she's just in the, eighth grade?
Eighth grade. And she's already a phenomenal athlete.
Yeah, she's good.
Wow. Well, that is great. I mean, that's good when you can see part of you coming along, doing well. A friend of mine also was telling me that you got another one of your grandsons in college, in early college. And I'd like to ask a little bit more about that, because education is huge around here in these parts. So, but before you answer that, what I want to do is to wind this down just for a little bit, because we need to take a break here and for our sponsors and all of that. And we want everyone to know the name of the show as we're going through. So I'll say it again. This is Extreme Carolina. And today our host, our guest is Mr. Clay Logan, the originator of the original possum drop. We'll come back after the break. We'll talk a little bit more about a little education and what we can do to help the folks in the community. So again, it's Michael Borkman with Extreme Carolina. We'll be right back.
Tar Heel basketball, Cam's Panthers, Asheville's eclectic nightlife, and the Great Smoky Mountains. It belongs to us too, out here in Extreme Carolina. Once again, here's Michael Borkman.
Well, welcome back, everybody, to the hot new show, Extreme Carolina, where today we're featuring Mr. Clay Logan, the originator of the world-famous possum drop, and also the proud grandpapa of the best or the prettiest granddaughter he's got. And she is an amazing golfer from what he talked about in the last segment. And a lot of the education in this country, it could be improved upon. But what I like is that you told a story off there, and I'd like for you to just kind of come back with that about your granddaughter, how she was trying to get into golf and trying to get to playing, but didn't have other girls or people her age is doing what she do, and so this came about.
Well, she does a lot of practice up at Chattoog, and Chattoog golf course lets the high school team come up there and practice and play for free. So she was up there one afternoon and didn't have nobody to play with, and the high school boys, the 10th, 11th, 12th team come up, and they said, well, you know, we'll let her play, but we'll go light on her. And they went too light on her because she beat every one of them.
Every one of them.
They so had eight crow.
Yeah, so her name and her fame began there.
Yep.
And how long ago was that?
That was last year.
Last year, okay. Yeah. So what grade, eighth grade, ninth grade?
She's eighth grade now.
Eighth grade now. Awesome. And also, speaking of grades, I understand that you have one of your grandsons is just now became last year in early college.
Right. He's a sophomore now, a combination sophomore high school and a sophomore. You get a two-year degree when you graduate down at Tri-County. That's a super program down there. And if you really want your kids to get ahead, okay, try to get them in that early college because it is a great program, and it's going real good down there. Yeah, and he really loves it. He wasn't real comfortable in high school.
Right.
And we got him in down there. Hey, he's doing great. He loves what he's doing. He interacts good with the adults. So it may not be for everybody, but the selected kids or the right kid for that program, they do great down there.
Now, the right kids, and that's a good point, Clay, the right kids. So how would I know my kid is the right kid? I'm a parent. Well, how do I know if I can get my kid into that program?
Well, you need to go down there and talk to their counselors and stuff and let them analyze your kid and see how he's doing in the regular school and stuff.
Okay, now that's at the early college?
Early college in Tri-County in Peachtree.
Okay, all right, okay. Not to throw a commercial out there,
right,
or a shout-out, but I'm going to throw a shout-out anyway.
Yeah.
I know Jason, he's one of the guys down there. But anyway, that's a good. So thank you for saying that, because we want our kids, which is the future of this world, of our life, is to be able to get as much education as possible. So you're saying that he is really – sprung up and done amazing since being a part of this program.
He certainly is. And the thing is about it, when he graduates, he's a senior, he's got a two-year degree.
Wow. So when he graduates from being in 12th grade, he's already got a two-year degree.
Got a two-year degree.
Wow. So it's worth us as parents to look into that program.
Yeah, boy.
I mean, because we're talking about how high the price is for college and everything. So it'd be great if our kid can already go in with 2 years under their belt. Of course, we know all of them won't do that, but we need to find out more about that.
Yep.
All right. Well, great. Well, thanks, man. We appreciate you sharing that little bit about us. And again, folks, today we're here talking to Clay Logan on the Extreme Carolina. And what I want to ask you about now, Clay, if that'd be okay with you, is that you've done a lot of things and you've been really, really extremely, extremely busy. And if you could, If you could mentor or give some advice to the younger Clay Logan, if you could advise the young Clay Logan, well, he's not got his back to the window because Clay don't like that. But anyway, but if you could give some advice to the younger Clay Logan, mentor him, what would that be?
That would be to figure out what you want to do in life. Because if you do something that you don't enjoy, you're miserable. You might do a decent job of it, but if you can find what you really want to do, you'll enjoy it. If you like what you're doing, you're going to really have fun down through life. It don't, you know, it don't have to be move off,
mm-hmm.
you know. If you want to live in your own community and right. your own county, if you've got the drive, you'll find something to do, uh-huh. and you'll find something you like to do.
And that's what you did. So the advice to your younger self would be to, so you're saying that was something that you didn't do, or but that you would do now that you know what you know.
Right. I stayed in my county, and unbeknownst to me, all three of my boys have stayed. One of them, the farthest one away, is in Silver, North Carolina.
Right.
So they're all local, you know, and they found, you know, a good decent job, and they like it here, and they like it because Grandma and Grandpa is real close, and we can look after the grandkids on weekends and stuff for them.
Yeah, ain't nothing like having a built-in a babysitter.
That's right.
One that you can count on.
That's what Clay's Corner was for years. They just drop them off at the store. But sometimes they picked them up as a little, wired up a little bit more, and we laid the candy to them, you know.
Well, matter of fact, I'm glad you brought that up, Clay's Corner. That was going to be my next question. I've heard about this back room at Clay's Corner. I haven't, and I'm ashamed to say, I haven't been there. So, and you're saying that your grandkids got a little more education. Was that because they was in the part of the back room? Or before you answer that, tell me what's this that I hear about this back room at Clay's Corner?
Well, it's a multi-use room, I'll put it like that. We have jam sessions every Friday night down there in it. And then Saturday morning, we let the ladies sleep in on Saturday morning. And we cook breakfast. And whoever wants to comes down, eats breakfast with us, and we sit around and talk. There's no charge or anything like that. It's just sort of like a family get-together, you know. And the jam sessions, we've been at that for 27 years now. So we've had a good variety of the good, the bad, the ugly, the best, the worst. We've had them all, and we've enjoyed every one of them, you know.
Wow.
It's a lot of fun.
Now, the jam sessions. Now, this, if I wanted to hear it or if I wanted to play, I could come either way on Friday nights at
right.
Clay's Corner.
Right.
And in the back room, there's, as you call it, a multi-use room down there at Clay's Corner. So all types of music is being played out of there?
Well, it's mostly bluegrass and old country.
Okay.
It's string instruments. We don't. Our room is so little, you couldn't bring a amplified something in there, you know.
Okay.
So it's basically flat tops and fiddles and banjos and and we have a piano player come through every now and then. So
awesome.
You know, it's just good clean fun.
Awesome. We need a lot more good clean fun. I guess my friend Patrick, though, him and his Modern Vinyl, they probably wouldn't take that as a good venue, but that's another story for another time.
Well, you know, they probably play flat tops and throw a little bluegrass or old country in there somewhere.
Yeah, I guess they probably could. That's great about the back room. So, and the women get to sleep in, and there's breakfast cooked on Saturday morning. What time would that be?
Well, we start cooking at 7:30. We have it ready about 8 to 8:15, according to how big a hurry we get.
Awesome. Well, that sounds real good, and that's the corner. That's in Clay's Corner down there at the Possum Drop. And you've been featured on all kinds of stations and newsreels and everything, and we really appreciate you coming in today and talking to us about Clay's Corner, talking about Clay granddaughter, partiest granddaughter that you got.
That's what I've got.
I love that.
Well, let me tell you a little bit about the possum drop right quick. It's
okay.
Everybody asked me, well, you can't use a live possum. Yes, we still using live possums. But we still got four lawsuits pending in Raleigh. You know, so wow. Everybody said, well, it's over with. No, it ain't over with, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, the last bill that was passed is in front of three judges to see if it's constitutional or not.
Right.
So if they rule that it is constitutional, then hopefully the other four lawsuits will go away.
Right.
But if it's not, then we're back to square one trying to figure out what's going on again. But we are still using a live possum.
Awesome. Well, thank you for that, Clay, and thank you for your time today. We appreciate it. We've run out of time, and I do apologize for that because I do love hearing the good stories. But thank you again for showing up here at Extreme Carolina, and we look forward to seeing you down the road.
Well, thank you, and I like Extreme Western Carolina because everybody thinks it stops in Asheville.
All right. Thanks, buddy. All right, take care.
17 hours, picking me a bouquet of dogwood flowers, and I'm hoping for Raleigh. I can see my baby tonight.